joining us for a quick chat is none other than Ranbir Kapoor. Ranbir, thank you so much for speaking to India today. My first question to you is, Aye Dil Hai Mushkil is just around the corner and there's a lot of buzz about the movie. You've been paired against with Aishwarya Rai Bachchan for the first time. How was it?
Well, you know, what do I say about Aye Dil Hai Mushkil? You know, it's my first opportunity to work with Karan Johar as a director. It's my second film with Anushka and of course Aishwarya Rai, you know, a woman who I have been besotted with, you know, who I personally have known for a long time since I was an assistant director on my father's film. And finally to romance her was quite surreal, but it was amazing, you know, and really excited the film's out in Diwali. You know, I think it's going to be a really fun love story. I think people will really identify and relate to the characters and the premise of the film. So really excited. And of course it has Preetam's music and I think it's definitely going to be one of the albums of the year.
I believe there are some intimate scenes in the movie with Aishwarya Rai Bachchan. Were either of you uncomfortable shooting them?
Who would be uncomfortable shooting intimate scenes with Aishwarya Rai Bachchan? But there's nothing of that kind. You know, it's a family film. It's not what it's made out to be. You know, sometimes reports are extremely exaggerated and unfair and unnecessary, and especially, you know, towards someone at the stature of Aishwarya Rai Bachchan. So nothing of that sort. But wait for the trailer, wait for the film, and you guys will be pleasantly surprised.
When can we expect the trailer launch?
I'm told 25th of August. Between the 23rd and 25th of August, once Karan comes back from his dream tour.
Also, recently a video went viral of you and Ranveer Singh on top of tables. I can't call it dance, I think it was sheer madness. Could you tell us something more about it?
Well, you know, firstly, it was our dear friend Jitesh's surprise party, and you know, we all have so much of love for him and his entire team. And you know, the entire fraternity when they come together, especially Ranveer, you know, he's got this amazing infectious energy. And always, whenever I met him at parties, we're always dancing, you know, for hours, doing crazy stuff. So it's always fun, and I always look forward to the next party with him.
There was a time after Ye Jawani Hai Diwani when you were declared the next, you know, blockbuster hero after the Khans, and somewhere that seems to have faded. Do you think Ranveer Singh has overtaken you in terms of box office performances and endorsements?
Well, I don't know. You know, I'm not. I don't follow statistics. But yes, Ranveer Singh is doing amazingly well, and I'm personally a big fan of his work also. And this is the film industry. You know, as actors, you do well, your films do well, then you're suddenly put up on a pedestal. Your films don't do well, and then you're kind of pulled down. But like I said earlier, you know, I'm very comfortable in the space I'm in with the kind of people I'm working. You know, not just Ranveer, if it's Varun, if it's Sushant Singh, if it's Tiger Shroff, Aritya Roy Kapoor, Siddharth Malhotra, the entire young bunch of actors are doing such amazing work. You know, I'm of course a little bit senior to all of them, so you know, I had a little bit of a lead, but now they all have caught, you know, with each other, and I think it's only going to keep us on our toes. We're only going to push each other to do better work, and I hope that in my next few films, you know, that people kind of give me back their love and respect.
What do you think has not worked for you in the last couple of years?
Well, you know, I can't pinpoint it. It's the movies, and if you have a formula for it, everybody would be successful. I just follow my heart, my gut. You know, I've always worked with amazing people, amazing directors. A film like Bombay Velvet, whatever happened to it, it's one of the most memorable experiences working on a film. So I think there's no failures, there are only lessons, you know. You know, at the risk of sounding pseudo and philosophical, you know, life is about, you know, beautiful moments and painful moments. Some of them are beautiful, some of them are painful, but mostly it's both of them. And, you know, you have to kind of take it in, you have to surrender to it, you have to accept it. And it only teaches you, it makes you stronger, it makes you a better person. And that's what I take from my failures, you know, as much as I've taken from my successes, that, you know, I have a long way to go. You know, I have so much to do, I have so much to achieve, so many people to work with. And I'm just raring to go. I'm rejuvenated, I'm refreshed, I'm passionate, eager, ambitious, and I have all these films to work on. So I'm really excited.
There are reports that you'd recently met your co-star, Jagga Jasoos co-star Katrina, at her house. Is that true?
It's absolutely untrue, you know, and I feel so sad, you know, that, you know, media, a section of media, you know, kind of, you know, promote or brainwash a certain side of audience, you know, with all of this, because as much as I would like to meet her, the last time I met her was, I guess, at the shoot of Jagga Jasoos, and I'm going to meet her now on the 10th of September when we restart Jagga Jasoos. So it's nothing, there's nothing true about that fact.
For all Ranveer and Katrina fans, is there any sort of a reconciliation or a patch-up that we can look forward to?
Thank you so much for coming, and I hope that you enjoy shopping at H&M.